I have been waiting for this moment for a very long time. Hey guys, I'm Gory B Movie and I'm a horror addict, and today we're going to be watching the trailer for Death House!
Yeah!
I am so excited for this movie. It has been called The Expendables of Horror because it has so many horror icons in it that we all know and love. Also, the movie was written by Gunnar Hansen, who played Leatherface in the original Texas Chainsaw Massacre. If that hasn't sold you, I don't know what will. Harrison Smith, who's directed a number of indie features like Zombie Killers, The Field, and Camp Dread, also worked on the script and is directing. And the movie stars seriously like everybody awesome that you would want in a movie. Adrienne Barbeau as the narrator, Michael Berryman, Barbara Crampton, Dee Wallace, Tony Todd, Sid Haig, Kane Hodder, Bill Moseley, Tiffany Shepis, Felissa Rose, Debbie Rochon, and the list goes on and on. Now, what the movie's about is there is this prison called the Death House where the most ruthless of criminals are housed, including whom I believe is the lead antagonist, played by Kane Hodder. Kane Hodder did talk about this a little bit at Crypticon 2016. He did say, in regards to it being called The Expendables of Horror, that a lot of these big names are only making small cameos and to not expect them to have big roles in the film. His role, from what I understand, is rather significant. And what happens is these two agents are going through the Death House when there is a massive power outage and they are trapped inside. And as they go deeper and deeper into the lower levels of the prison, they find that there are supernatural creatures in there that, I don't know, want to eat them or something. It sounds awesome. Enough with the hype. Let's watch the trailer already.
The Death House, established in 1954 under the Eisenhower administration, serves as a federal prison, medical, psychological, and parapsychological research center.
Agent Novak, meet your fellow graduate, Agent Toria Boone.
Welcome to Death House. Does it live up to what you study?
Ask me again in 12 hours.
Summer dose with just LSD.
Barbara Crampton and Dee Wallace!
Shock, sensory deprivation, all to break down the subject's personality.
She's amazing in everything.
Rise is waiting for you and your girl.
Sid Haig.
Our goal is to eradicate evil.
I will fuck you in hell.
Jesus Christ!
Ever any talk of the five evils?
What the fuck?
You have to be careful.
Don't you have something special lined up to kill everybody inside this hellhole?
Tell me you're both armed.
Better be armed. Oh, I would not want to be stuck in there. Tony Todd!
Something.
I know everything, Novak.
Oh, I love Dee Wallace.
We gotta find a way up.
Wow.
I am immortal.
Oh, there's RA.
We need to get out of here.
I will follow you to hell. The way out is not that way. It's down to them.
Yeah, hell no. No way in hell I would go down there.
We forgot to close the elevator shaft.
Jump scares! What the fuck is that? What was that thing? That was freaking awesome. I don't even know where to start. We saw Kane Hodder just being a total fucking badass. I swear, I've met Kane Hodder a few times in person, and he is one of the most intimidating people you will meet, and he brings that to screen every time. He's just a fantastic presence on screen. And Dee Wallace and Barbara Crampton, and What the hell was that thing at the end that was all like Hellraiser-y? You know, like Uncle Frank coming up from the floorboards all gooey and bloody and stuff. It's probably these creatures that are in the down below area that are going to be attacking the protagonists. I like all the claustrophobic scenes we're seeing in there where they're going down corridors and such. I'm looking forward to that. The lighting looked awesome. I mean, yes, this does look like it's a low budget indie movie, but personally, I prefer a lot of those movies. I think that's where you find your hidden gems. And as long as the story is good, I'm gonna be happy with this film. What was confusing were the parts where they were glitching out a bit. It looked like maybe they were holograms. Barbara Crampton looked like a hologram at one point, and there was backgrounds that were glitching. Kind of reminded me a bit of Cabin in the Woods when they got to the outer perimeter of the testing area. I have no idea what that's about. This is very kind of sci-fi meets horror. So it could be really good. It could be like a sci-fi TV movie. I'm gonna hope for the best and say it's gonna be good because it looks good. I cannot wait to find out when this actually comes out because I know it's coming out this year, but we still haven't gotten a release date on it. I'm willing to bet this is gonna be a movie that's gonna be released straight to DVD, VOD. So I'm gonna keep scouring the webs, and as soon as I find out, I will post it on my VOD list that I keep updated on Letterboxd. I have a list on there of every movie that's been released on VOD, DVD for 2017. That's horror. So if you want release dates, you want to stay up to date, you want to take advantage of my insane nerdiness, go onto Letterboxd. You can find me on there. Either look up Horror Addicts or Gory Bee Movie. And I have lists on there of loads of other things, you know, romantic horror movies, found footage movies, werewolf movies. Seriously, there's a lot of lists. So go check it out and let me know in the comments what you guys thought of this trailer. I hope you guys are as excited as I am because I think this is going to be great. But I want to hear from you guys. Let me know, comments below, what you think. And of course, if you guys want to see more trailer reactions like this one, do hack that thumbs up button. And of course, if you're new here, subscribe and ring that bell so you get notifications on all of our upcoming videos where we review all things horror all the time. Thanks for watching.